Oh, no, that's a nice snapper there. That's a solid snapper.
Just let him eat that. Let him eat. He'll eat that. He'll eat that. Just let him eat it. You're a bait runner on, eh?
Oh, he's on it.
He's on it. The snapper grabbed it.
Let him eat.
How good's that? We're sight fishing.
Let him eat.
For our Hunting and Fishing New Zealand Tackle Top this week, we're going to look at catching fish off the rocks, which is different from surf casting or just generic land-based fishing. You've got to have specific rock fishing gear. So I've got my snapper rock rods, I've got a topwater setup, and I've got a land-based game fishing rod. All of that gear that you've seen right there, we review and show you how to set up right from all of the knots, how to spool them up at ultimatefishing.tv. But there's also more gear that I just won't jump on the rocks without. A decent pack. So pack with lots of straps for putting your rod tubes in, compartments for tackle boxes. Inside there I've got all the essentials, sunblock, first aid kit, rescue beacon. There's a few other things that just make that day a little bit better for you when you're on the rocks. A hand towel, I just tuck it in the side of my trousers when you've got messy bait that you don't want to get all over your fishing gear. Of course, some bait knives, nice little bit of plywood, just so you've got something to cut onto with your baits. The plywood you can't get from Hunting and Fishing, but you can get it from ITM. A bat, taking care of the fish that you catch. These things, Rocky Rock Spikes. Jam it in the crack, give it a bit of a whack, and there you go, you've got an instant rod holder. Burley bag, always have at least a couple of these because they do get chewed up by snapper and sharks, and plenty of rope to tie your burley bag on. You can take a look at all of our land-based fishing essentials in detail at ultimatefishing.tv, and all of the gear and more is available at your local Hunting and Fishing New Zealand store.